Behind all the blockbuster success stories out of Silicon Valley, there are scores of ideas that just don't make it. And some die a pretty slow death. Special correspondent Steve Goldbloom has our story.
We've got a great name, we've got a great team, we've got a great logo, and we've got a great name. Now we just need an idea. Let's pivot.
HBO's comedy Silicon Valley lampoons startup culture in the Bay Area. But for those working in the tech scene, it's like art imitating life. In other words, people really do talk that way.
Pivot is a great one.
Killing it, crushing it.
Disrupt is the classic one.
Rock stars, ninjas, Jedis.
Lean in.
Fail fast.
Growth hacker, which is actually just marketing.
I think it's, you know, the social network movie that over-romanticized how easy it is for college students to become a $100 billion company.
Relationship status, interested in.
There is no shortage of messianic language.
Natasha Takeu is an editor at ValleyWag, which is owned by Gawker Media. They're like the Us Weekly of tech. She explains some of the hyperbole behind startups.
They all want to start a movement. They all want to start a revolution. It's particularly funny because once one person said they were going to change the world, if you present just like a simple app, you know, what are you going to do next to that?
She says it's no good to have a straightforward idea anymore. It has to be groundbreaking.
Entrepreneurs show up here in the Bay Area with dreams of turning their scrappy startup into the next big thing. But the reality is most of them don't work out.
We help very early stage companies get started.
Sam Altman runs Y Combinator, a Silicon Valley firm that mentors entrepreneurs. It's called an incubator, which is basically a camp for startups. Altman is like a rock star for young entrepreneurs. A Stanford dropout, he launched an app at age 20 and sold it 7 years later for nearly $40 million.
The magnitude of problems that go wrong is one of the surprising things about young startups. One day, your product is not working. The next day, a patent troll is suing you. The next day, a competitor is taking your users. The day after that, your key employee quits.
Y Combinator helps young startups avoid these pitfalls. The program has graduated some heavy hitters, too, like Dropbox and Airbnb, both now valued in the billions. But these are the exceptions. A more common path is the one taken by Yin-Yin Wu and Shu-Yin Chow from the Y Combinator class of 2013. They created a business that was going to be the Uber of dry cleaning.
Where you could push a button and we would pick up your laundry, wash, fold, and return it the same day. We found that business model didn't really work.
When we're really demoralized, we ask ourselves, is it our problem or is it objectively the market problem?
We come from a perspective of, oh, we're going to, you know, be really successful if we just work hard. And that's just not true with startups.
Wu and Chow are now developing a phone notification app for Android. They've pivoted. But what if they hadn't thrown in the towel?
Not every company dies fast.
Gary Kremen is a veteran entrepreneur and investor in the Valley. Remember that 90s craze of buying domain names? Well, Kremen was pretty much ahead of the curve on that. He made an early fortune registering sites like jobs.com, auto.com, and sex.com.
Entrepreneurs, they don't like to give up. A company will shrink down when they're almost out of money to six people, getting internet from Starbucks and them not even ordering Starbucks, probably bringing a cup of water there in an old Starbucks cup and keep working on it and working on it. They're not dead, but they're not alive, kind of like zombies.
That's actually what they're called here, startup zombies. A company that's not succeeding or failing, it's just burning investors' money by staying alive. Here's where Gary Kremen and his partner Michael McTagg come in. They founded the company Cap Gain Solutions, registered privately as Zombie Apocalypse Holdings, LLC. They buy zombie companies so that the investor can write off the losses on their tax return. In other words, they kill zombies.
To make them dead so you can use the tax losses, you'd sell those companies' interest to us, and we'd allow you to realize your gains.
We're like the 1-800 junk king. You have some junk, we'll come by, we'll get it. We'll take it out of your house and we'll try to resell it at a later date for more money than we paid.
In a state with 53% tax rates, that loss is worth a lot of money to me.
Ben Black is a venture capitalist and uses Cap Gain Solutions.
I turn to Gary and say, here's the situation, I need you to buy the stock. He buys it, I get my letter, I get my loss.
Another way out of zombie purgatory is to be acquired by a more established firm. That's what's called an acqui-hire.
An acqui-hire is an exit for a company, primarily for the team and the experience that those people have.
Jacob Mullins runs Exit Round.
People describe us as either something like an eBay for companies or as like a Match.com or a Tinder for companies.
As a matchmaker, Mullins has plenty to work with. According to the online tracker Crunchbase, 19,500 companies received venture capital funding last year.
Well, it's clear that we're in the middle of a boom. Some people might call it a bubble. And what that means for startups in particular is a lot of VCs are willing to fund 10 companies with the idea that one of them is Twitter.
But that still leaves 9 companies that won't be the next Twitter. Are they doomed to become startup zombies? And if we are in a bubble, how much longer can that go on?
Every 2 to 3 years, there's an investment cycle.
Steve Gerbsman is a crisis management expert for businesses in need of an exit strategy. His forecast isn't so bright.
You had the investment cycle starting in 11 and 12. We haven't had the bust yet, but it's coming, because every 2.5 to 3 years after the investment cycle, our business gets good.
Meanwhile, entrepreneurs will continue to take big swings, and a cottage industry of valley types will be there to profit when they miss. As for the zombies, there's always Halloween. For the NewsHour in San Francisco, I'm Steve Goldbloom.